me getting more scared as time grew on. They helped me take a deep breath and calm myself. Thank you to Herb and Nelly and my friends, I was able to calm myself so that when I walked on stage with the rest of my team, I was calm and I was ready. I looked straight in front of me, and in the doorway, standing up, there were a couple of my family stood. All I could do was smile, and all my fears disappeared. It was a great show. I realized after the show that I didn't understand why I was afraid. I had performed with my team in front of thousands of people in 5 different competitions. We made the finals at our last competition. I realized my greatest fear when performing is when I am performing in front of people that I love and care about. According to Marla, the author of Performing Anxiety, everyone has their different reasons behind why they get stage fright. They can be family members or just the massive crowds that even school performances can bring because of the students within the ensembles. We all have experience in this. I mean, most of the concerts in this theater is packed with people. For some, there are people crowded in standing in the aisles. Even though I've had those experiences over the past year, here I am standing in front of all of you, telling you about stage fright adrenaline and the things I have overcome. Trust me when I say, stage fright is hard to overcome, but it can be done. I am so proud of the many opportunities I've had this year and the things I've done. I don't regret any of it. Thank you for supporting us, and thank you for being here and listening to me. I hope you enjoyed my take on the relationship between stage fright and adrenaline.
We'd like to welcome you to a night of a little bit of new and a little bit of old classic music, the masterpieces that define choir and orchestral music in today's repertoire. So we hope that you enjoy the evening and that you're inspired and that something moves you emotionally. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. again, thank you so much for coming out to our masterpiece tonight and joining the orchestra and all the choirs here at PCHS. Just a couple announcements before we perform our last two pieces for you. Directly following the concert, there will be a brief 10 to 15 intermission where orchestra families and students who are welcome to gather in the cafeteria for your awards presentation after the intermission, as well as enjoy some refreshments. Choir families, you have 10 to 15 minutes to go to the bathroom, take a break, get situated, as we get situated for our awards portion of the ceremony here in the theater. These next two pieces were written by Latvian composer Eric Eschenbaltz. They both have very different texts, but they both express hope through their beautiful poetry as well as their music. We are going to perform both of these works immediately after the other one, so please hold your applause until after I leave. Thank you.